Okay. I thought we won't sit for just about 15 more minutes, I think, just to do a little more meditation, but does anyone want to say anything? I mean, that was a lot of ground we covered. Are you okay, John and Roxanne? And
I just want to say it was a very beautiful meditation.
Yeah.
There's a lot of merit in meditating in a group.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I can't say I was taking in every word that you read out,
mm.
but there was just a very beautiful
mm.
stillness.
Mm. Yeah, that is a, it's at Rinpoche.com. Very easy to remember that.
Is there a title to
the Ganges Mahamudra? The River Ganges, you know, the Ganges Mahamudra.
I thought I'll just say Tadyatha. That means so be it to a
yes.
certain extent. And then Om Muni Muni Maha Muni.
Yeah.
That means Muni is like sage or a guru.
Oh, okay.
So, Guru Guru
yeah.
and Maha
Great
Guru, great guru.
Yeah.
And then
Swaha.
Swaha means like you dissolve in it. Or that means you be absorbed or you dissolve in it.
Oh, becoming
so,
oneness with
so that I think it has a similar understanding of Om Mani Padme Hum.
Yeah.
Just connecting to that
yeah.
finish.
Yeah.
I think that has same.
Well, I'm glad you said that because somebody
yeah.
told me it means control.
I yeah, I think it does. I mean, that it comes from that root. So the sage, the Muni, the sage, is the one who
yeah.
has control. These controls his mind.
Yeah.
Yeah.
yeah. I think I'd prefer to think of someone who's released his mind from all delusions. You know, I like to think of it more that way. You know, control is like, I'm sitting on it.
Yeah.
I let it go, you know.
But it's different ways to control, aren't there? I mean,
yeah.
yeah. Like Shunryu Suzuki said.
Yeah.
The best way to control your sheep is to keep them in a big spacious
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. And the other translation I heard was capable.
Capable.
That you can be, that relating to oneself, that you are capable.
Can you speak louder? I think so.
Oh, sorry. capable. That you are capable. And the more you practice, the more capable you become to reaching enlightenment.
Mm-hmm.
So,
thank you. Well, I was just thinking that, you know, in Dharma there's kind of like two main threads. And one of them is this emptiness side, but the other side is the great love and compassion. So, and when all else fails, you can definitely go there, because that's something that we do know. You know, emptiness is something that we can understand intellectually, but not really feel.
Mm-hmm.
You know, but love, that's one of the things that Dalai Lama says, we can know love, we can feel love. And so it's important to work with that and let ourselves feel it more and more. Because like I said last night, we think that we need an object to feel love, but in actual fact, love just comes from our own hearts. So if we can learn to just sit in this non-objectifying compassion, is what Lama Zopi uses the word, you know, just being love rather than doing love, then it's a very healing thing. And so I thought we might give it a try. Just for another 10 minutes, and then we'll, you know, got something to say if something comes up. You know, a lot of times you're meditating when you get your best thoughts. When you think you're trying to stop your thoughts, your best thoughts come. So that's okay too. But I just wanted to say that another really good way to get a kind of a handle on Mahamudra meditation is just going to a place where you have a long distance view and just sitting and relaxing and looking out. You know, and just letting yourself relax, but at the same time remain focused on what's going on, you know. And just allow yourself to kind of blend with that quality of spaciousness. You know, like sitting on top of a hill or sitting on the edge of the sea, or just kind of letting yourself feel space, you know, and feel that vastness. And just notice that how your mind is, say you're looking at the ocean or you're looking at a tree, it's not like you have to go out and jump in the ocean and grab that wave. You just watch the waves coming and going. And that's how it is with the mind, you know. We don't have to just grab that mind, that thought, and hold on to it. We can just kind of sit back, like we're sitting back and watching the clouds go by in the sky. You know, we want to So it's helpful to actually do those kinds of things, just like watch the clouds go by in the sky and watch, you know, just look out at space and just let yourself do nothing and just become familiar with that spaciousness where thoughts are coming and going. When you do that, it really helps a lot, which is why I think, you know, in Tibet, the monasteries were always, at least the hermitages were up in these places where they had a long view, you know. A long view actually helps. So just let your mind become oneness with space. And just let your eyes gaze out, you know, and it really helps the mind to de-intensify and relax. And then when you're meditating, you kind of remember that experience too, when you're back in your flat or wherever you live, you know. So, yeah. And I also think when you're in a place like that, it's also easier to feel that sense of connectedness and love, you know, because it's so inspiring to be in a beautiful place. Anyway, so let's just sit for again with our bodhicitta motivation. To attain enlightenment for sentient beings, we're just going to be practicing being present in the moment as best as we can. So again, we'll take as our object people that we love, or things that we love, animals we love, and those beings that love us. And if you want to include your, if you have a guru, the guru loving you. And we'll just do the breathing meditation, and we'll just go back to what we did a little bit earlier, just breathing in love. And just when we exhale, just allowing ourselves to relax. And just settle in that experience of the kind of warm feeling that it comes with that. once we have the sense of filling ourselves up with this light that's in the nature of love, of course we're still, you know, watching our mind and bringing our mind back to that object, which is basically just a spacious mind and body that's in the nature of love. We can imagine that our body is made of light, and as we breathe in the love from the guru or our best friend or our parent or our grandmother, or even just imagine, or even just from ourselves, or Christ or God or whoever you want to, wherever your source is, you breathe it into yourself. And then you imagine it fills up your body with light, and you can visualize it as white light or rainbow light. And then we're going to extend that out through the pores of our skin and give it out to everyone in this room, so that we begin to see this room as a room just full of rainbow light connecting all of us together and going around, just sort of putting us in a big ball of rainbow light. Then we can fill up this room, and it's now almost like we're a unit, a working, some kind of aggregate of light and love goes out to this room, and into this neighborhood in Leeds. Touching every person in this neighborhood that's suffering, and giving them this sense of safety, security, and love. A sense that they'll be okay, that all is forgiven, no matter what they've done or who they are, that their basic nature is loved and is love. City so we could imagine all the thousands of people in their little homes, and not only that, but the dogs and the cats and the rats and the birds and the foxes and the snakes and insects. Hedgehogs, hares, all enveloped in this rainbow light. That feels safe and forgiven and loved. into Yorkshire. And England, Scotland, and Wales. Healing all the divides. All the injustices, all the mistakes, all the greed. All the insecurities, and low self-esteem, and self-hatred. And every time we breathe in, it grows stronger, and our group gets stronger, and it keeps moving out and out and out and out into the ocean, into Iceland and Greenland and Norway and France. Going out and out and out until we can visualize the whole planet. And beyond. Lots of space. Then we'll just take a moment to sense this agent that's experiencing the love and giving it out. And just, if we can, focus the mind on the sense of me that's doing it. Because I've been receiving love the whole time too. And then just take a moment to see if we can actually find that me somewhere in my mind and my body. We can't find it, we're just left with pure awareness. Just awareness, aware of body, breathing, love, room, space, light. Without really having to conceptualize it, just resting in this freedom and relaxation. Mahamunaye so taya sending that energy right out around the world to all sentient beings. You can think that whatever causes we created today for enlightenment, for realizing Mahamudra, for making the world a more tolerant, peaceful, loving, intelligent place, that we dedicate that to that, to the world becoming a more intelligent, wise, compassionate place, and to the enlightenment of ourselves.